Warning, please do not attempt the toy destruction you see in this video at home. Leave this sort of work to the lousy professionals. Well, hello, welcome to a dark side video. This is a very opportunistic dark side video because up inside the box there on my table is a whole bunch of knockoff toys related to Pokemon, especially Pokemon Go. Let me get this stuff out. This haul of knockoff toys is actually very alarming. It's showing me how fast the dark side moves on something. Pokemon Go sort of kicked off in July, the way I remember it, July 2016. I first started seeing these toys, or knockoff toys for sale in Australia. It was roughly 2 months after I saw the initial kick in of Pokemon Go. Some of these knockoffs look just like you will find the Pokemon toys in the store. I have got some real toys to look at along the way. Yet other ones look just awkward, would be the best way I could say it. Maybe the Pokeballs like that are fairly awkward looking. I'm not going to linger on one thing for too long. I have a lot of knockoff toys to destroy here, and I'm going to try and get all this done in this one video. If I feel like the video is getting a bit too long, well, I can always come back for another bite. Let me gently clear this out. Oh, Mr. Hammer's starting already. Mr. Hammer! Mr. Hammer! Woo! Okay, the first item we're going to strike a note with is a Pokemon Go ukulele. Yay! I believe these came in different colours, although I only ever saw pink. I think the back of the box reveals more. Yeah, there's different colours there. I think it's actually set in the different Pokemon Go teams. Up the end it tells you how to tune it and do something else with it. I think the other end it shows the Pokemon Go teams. You can see it cost me $15. There's also some little toys in here as well. I bet you it's a horror thing to play. Let's carefully unbox this and see how it plays. Okay, the ukulele is free. Strike me a note. Yeah, baby, yeah! Classic sort of rubbish dark side toys. Team Valor, this one's based on. You can see the Pokemon Go critters there, and if I go up to the head of this ukulele, there's some more Pokemon Go artwork. $15 of dark side goodness, and I've actually got a little friend who knows how to tune things like this. His name is Mr. Hammer. Apart from tuning ukuleles, Mr. Hammer can belt out a pretty good tune. Sounding better already. Mr. Hammer, you struck the right chord, and your handiwork is always appreciated. When we're thinking about Pokemon and Pokemon Go ripoffs, I think most people would concur with me that plush toys and trading cards is where it's really hot. We'll be taking a look at the trading cards maybe later, Wooshka, but we're going to do the plushes right now and not spend too much time on them because, in a sense, plush toys can be super boring because they can seem so much like the real ones. Is that a Raichu? This is one I picked up right at the start of the Pokemon Go craze. Often they've got suction cups. That's the way I sort of think that they're fake, but there's no tag on these. It really relates back to the owners of Pokemon or anything. I think that's the thing that really sort of designates these ones. Although you can see very clever clones, which can be quite foolish. And it's funny, we had this Mudkip for some time now. It's got a bit grubby. It was such a difficult one to find, and in the end we found the real one, and it's when you put the real one up against this you start to see where it's all falling apart. Let me reach over and get a real Pokemon Mudkip. As you can see, I paid $15. I think the high price might have been $18 or $20. It's got tags on it. It's got a very nice tag. This one's still in its box for purposes of showing you this video. Really, I wanted to show you how it's set up. There's a real Tomy tag down there. As you can see, it comes in a box. That's the way it gets presented in store. It looks nice. Now, if I sit this Mudkip up against our knockoff, then you start to see there is a huge difference between the two of them. I'll come in and carefully get this one out of box here. Had you worried there for a moment, didn't I? Okay, it is free of the box, and I'll stand it up properly next to our faker. It becomes a bit like chalk and cheese when you see them side by side like that. I'm glad I ended up finding the real one, and it was a good lesson for my daughter to see that versus the one she thought she liked. This is one we bought in the markets, and she thought it was the best thing since sliced bread, when in reality it's just not very nice at all versus the real toy. Online, I just see so many knockoffs of these types of toys for sale. You have to be really careful that you're not paying too much for these. And I'll just show you the Tomy tag here. There's a look at the tag on the real Mudkip, but sadly I've seen knockoff toys which have got, you know, incredibly good looking tags as well. Just because it looks real in the tag department sometimes doesn't mean it's a real toy. Let's just very quickly look at the knockoff one. See that there? Yeah, hey, what do you reckon? Would you be fooled by that if you saw that? Or would you be worried? There were some great websites up that explained eBayers who were selling the knockoff Pokemon plushes. I don't know whether those websites are still up. I remember looking at those, it was about a year and a half back. But so often as I find with the knockoff plushes, they are sort of malformed. They just don't have the right shape. They come close to the shape, but the little bits of detail and niceties that you'll see in the real toys just don't happen on the knockoffs. And the other thing I notice is with the knockoffs is their stitching will come undone really easily. Yeah, welcome to the dark side. I will gently put the real Mudkip to the side, and I've got a bit of a hot date for these other fakers. Okay, you knockoff Pokemon plushies. Some people say you're a hot toy, let's just see how hot you can get. Had these terrible spider problems lately and I found a new weapon. Nice flamethrower. It looks like the Pokemons are struggling to take that heat. Well, they are really opening up. You're not looking so hot now. Well, mind you, you're feeling hot. I'm sure there was a fake Mudkip there. It seems to have just vanished. Wow, I am really astonishing how fast these things are burning up. It's actually very, very scary. Well, if you ever run out of firewood at winter time, you know what to throw on the fire. They'll heat your house. Not for very long, that's the problem. I'm sure the craze is called Pokemon Go, not Pokemon Gone. I've often wondered whether the real plushies burn as vigorous and scary as the knockoff ones. Moving right along, the next Pokemon Go Pikachu we're going to take a look at resides in this box. The box is all about lurching you in, because if you're into Pokemon Go, you're going to get excited seeing this, aren't you, hey? Flashing lights. Yeah, I wonder how much flashing goes on in this thing. I haven't got a price on this. I think it was around about $10. I've noticed things are either like $10 or $15. Let's get this thing out of here gently. Come on, out you come. Come to Papa. Okay, here is this thing here. It is one of those really, really tough plasticky things. It's a money box. Pikachu, it has got flashing lights in there, things that are flashing. Maybe if I turn the lights off, we'll see how angry it looks. Don't be scared, boys and girls. This is a knockoff flashing Pikachu. I've got to really hit it to make it activate. Maybe you're impressed with that, maybe you're not. You can actually make the flashing thing go to its head if you want. You can make it go to its feet, but I just like banging it on the table. The lights are back on, but I'm still banging away. It is a money box, and I thought, well, how do you get the money out if you put money in? I think its head pops off. And then, well, apart from a bit of extra plastic, that's the flashing unit there. Now, how deadly and dangerous is that thing? Well, I've got to tap this thing to make it work. How dangerous is that? Look at the size of that thing. If a child pulled this out of that money box and it goes down a young child's throat, it's going to burn a child's throat. It's going to kill them. Okay, I think that's one of the most dangerous things that I've ever found inside a knockoff toy. I've seen some stupidly dangerous things out of knockoff toys, but that's one of the worst. This type of vinyl, it's extremely difficult to blow up. It'd be very hard for Mr. Hammer to make an impact. I think I'm going to pack it with sparklers and give him a pyro send-off. Okay, here is Mr. Knockoff Moneybox Pikachu. I've drilled some holes for the eyes. We might see flames coming out of there, and also drilled a hole at his mouth. It's time to light him up. Okay, the fuse is lit. Any moment he's going to blow. Remember, we're looking for flames out of the eyes and the mouth. Mind you, that is a very, very cool look. Smoking. And what is sort of surprising is how that money box has survived. I told you they were very tough. Well, I've got a little friend who can finish him off. That's more like it. That's looking more like it. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Pikachu is down. Pikachu is down. That is one very, very stenchy, stinking Pikachu. Incredibly robust, wasn't it? A flamethrower certainly sent it to the next dimension. Our next Pokemon Go knockoff horror item is down on the table here. It's just called a flashing sword. It's got all the artwork that's going to lure children to this item. It was $10. You can see that for me. There were lots of these in store. It was quite a popular thing to see in the wrong parts of town. That's the artwork on the back. More things like that down there, and things like that which always remind me of what I see on Dark Side stuff. It makes sounds like this. There is a flashing light in there. It's also got a lever there, but I don't know what that does. It looks like maybe it shoots something out the side there, but I can't quite work it out. And did you know, I've actually got a little friend here who likes to work things like that out. Mr. Hammer, can you sort that switch out for me? Yep, he certainly can. Whoa, smashing work there, Mr. Hammer. And look at that, you're even showing us the horrible sound chip that generated those terrible sounds from that knockoff toy. Nice work indeed. Well, I've got to hand it to Mr. Hammer. He is fast, he is efficient, and he unboxes things like nothing else around. Mooching on to the next items, and these were very, very common and seen in all sorts of places and all sorts of prices as well. Little double sets like these figures here were selling for $2, but some places had them for $5. The prices really did vary. A set like that was selling for $10. The price is right in the middle of there. A set like that is $7, as you can see. A set here like this, and look at the artwork and the way it's set up, $7. And a large set like this, remembering the artwork, it's about luring you in, a set like that was $20. This $20 set does have some very awkward looking figures in here. I can't name all of these Pokemons. I know the Pokemon fans will tell me what's going on here, whether they are real things or not. Then again, this little $7 set, if you have a close scrutiny here, those Pikachus in there don't look too bad. Again, it's all about that artwork trying to lure you in. The little sets as well, to me, they looked pretty close to the real deal. So you've got a feel for what the Dark Side was offering up and the prices. I have got some real Pokemon toys here. In Australia, this double pack here of Pikachu and Mudkip is a $10 toy. It's a Tomy toy. I tell you what, I bet you it's awesome. There were lots of these in store. There's other packs to get as well. And there was Ash here with Pikachu, and I think that's a $15 toy, or I might be... I hope I'm close to the mark there. I haven't got a price on this. But once again, it looks pretty Pokemon awesome. I'm trying to condense the time of my videos. I'm only going to take a look at this set here, and also this really, really crummy set here. Ones I'm not looking at, I may repurpose those later on. Let's take a look at the artwork on this. There's a very strange read there. It's like a jagged bolt of lightning. Did we know that? On the back of the box, it looks like this. Okay, there is all sorts of Pokemon blah blah going on in there. There's a very strange Dark Side read there. A bit hard on your eyes. You can pause the video if you want to examine that further. It's all about hauling the children in, and with Pokemon Go as the game, the app game, I think what's happened is it's transitioned to basically children playing it. This is the other set. It's very rough nut looking. I mean, it's one of those ones where it's just painted rough as well. And the back of the box is fairly entertaining, as we're going to take a look here. There's a whole bunch of very strange looking artwork there that you may rejoice in. There's a nice Dark Side read there. Get your box of tissues out because you'll be crying of laughter. And there's another clanger Dark Side read there. You'll be pausing to read this one. I can't see how many of the things there have any relationship to what's in this box. And to finish it off, obviously we're collecting slugs. Never knew that. Let me come in and unbox this larger one first with the roughed up figures. And we will take a look at some of these, not all of them. Ooh, and the first touchy-feely thing often, yeah, they're greasy feeling. It's like when they come out of the mold, they don't clean them. And the smell, there's a very, very particular smell to these. In fact, I'm recognizing some of these from playing Pokemon Go. I think that was that snoring one. I've actually forgotten its name. That monkey, what is that? It doesn't even look like its tail's come off. There you go, welcome to the Dark Side already. Choking hazard immediately out of the box. This one here, I know you guys will name it. I can't, and there's Pikachu, and it just... It just feels horrible. The smell from this box here is putrid, and there's Pikachu's tail. You can choke on that if you want. Who was the girl in this? Who is she? Is that Ash's girlfriend? She got very short shorts on, she's a bit naughty. And there were the very, very strange thing there. I was going to say something, but it'd be too rude for children's entertainment. It's very, very strange. Well, I'll dump these guys out nice and gently. And it's worthy to look here. There is some artwork on the back of the box. And often the dark side will go online and they'll just rip off someone's artwork. Sometimes it's someone's custom artwork. Maybe the Pokemon Go fans can ID that one for me. These figures, some of them are okay. I'm going to use the word okay. I'm not going to use the word good. You can see it's made up of a couple of components. This one has come out of the mold fairly well. I'll only look at a couple of these. I believe that's Ash and he's holding a Pokeball. It's a bit rough nut in painting. It's a bit edgy on the seam of the plastic of this thing. Sharpie in some spots. I've seen worse, put it that way. When I've got ones like this in my hand, it's very, very sharp on the edge. Extremely sharp. You can see it's not quite finished off properly. I've got no idea who or what that is. It's a small one. The Pikachu here, I've actually lost its tail. Its tail's fluttered away from my manic unboxing method. Yeah, it's probably just a direct rip of a real toy. I know the Pokemon fans are going to tell me it's very edgy as well. You see, it's just a bit rough nut on the way it's been finished. The people who make these don't care. Let's see if I can rip his ear off, how easy it is. Yeah, ears come off pretty easy. Look at that, hey? Welcome to the dark side. I choked on his ear, and I died. This thing here, you just see how rough that's been finished off, roughly painted, you know. What's another rough one? This one here, I think. I've got no idea of their names. Pokemon's one of these things, there's like billions of variations. Okay, so don't get excited by this, they're worth zero. I've already sort of had a good look at that one, I think. There's that thing there, looks like a, I don't know. I think in Pokemon Go, it's probably worth zero, that thing. It's a real pain in the neck sort of thing, a sort of weird monkey looking thing. Which for some reason reminds me of something else. Nah, it's just rubbish, and I think that's Snorlax, isn't it? Yeah, you can see it's not properly finished around the ear there. Yeah, rough nut paint job, what do you expect? And of course, the girl again. Gotta look at the girl. I just unboxed this real Mudkip and Pikachu because I think it's worth taking a look at the quality of the real toy versus the knockoff. Gently unbox these guys. Because it's the real toy, you get a real leaflet with it and it explores the whole collectability of this toy, and it's one of these things that will just go on and on forever. I saw some of these in store, but there were a lot of these ones I didn't see. Yeah, it was very hot there for the moment, back in the winter holidays in Australia, and there's a nice sort of picture there going across all the things that are available. And to get a nice hard up comparison, I'll probably take a Pikachu out of this box here. So you can see dark side versus real toy. I think that's really important to study. This is the real Pikachu. There is licensing on his little lightning bolt on the tail there, and that's very important to take note of. As you can see, it is very well finished off. It looks nice. You know, this is the sort of thing that is collectible and you're going to have a lot of fun and joy with it. Mind you, it is a Raz expensive. This is a knockoff one. If you're impressed by that, please go and see a doctor. You shouldn't be impressed by it. There's no licensing on this thing. It can be as cheap as chips, but in collectability value, it's worth nothing. It's one of those things you could probably just rip the lightning bolt off this guy. Bang, he's now powerless. That's the real one. Do you think I should try and rip his tail off? Let's have a go, eh? It's quite hard to pull off. In fact, it's very hard to pull off. I am stretching it there, but it's not coming off as easy as a knockoff. Think I should go all the way? I bet not, or else you get angry with me. But yeah, hopefully you can see the big difference between the real toy there in my hand and the knockoff, who's screaming because he's just lost his tail. These are the other Pikachus from that set. There's nothing impressive here. I could just rip that tail off in an instant, I'm sure. There's that one there. I don't know why they're dressed like that. Is it like a little St. Patrick's Day one? I know the audience will tell me why Pikachu's dressed like that. And there's like the sort of fat cat one. Once again, I don't understand why he looks like that. I know you'll ask, Leo, can you please show the real Mudkip? This is the real toy, the licensed one. It looks nice, doesn't it? Nice double set that, Pikachu and Mudkip. I didn't see Mudkip in the knockoff like I thought I would, because I know he's a very, very popular little Pokemon. I know both my children like Mudkip. Well, there's a little Pokemon, knockoff Pokemon family, reveling in the sunshine. Little do they know there's going to be a horrible storm that comes through and wrecks their hairdo.
When you're hot, you're hot. And when you're not, you're not.
What a shame to see those Pokemon toys going up in flames. Next up, it's the knockoff Lego brick Pokemon Go, if that makes any sense. Down on the table, these were the designs that I saw. There were big boxes in some shops of these Lego, or should I say knockoff minifigures. They were $2 a pop. I've built two of them up. You get a bit of a surprise, I think, and my son certainly liked the look of these as well. Noticing the artwork, Pokemon Go SL Toys, this one here, I think it's called Gengar, is that what it says in the box? I've made this one up. It comes with a little digital device as well. Sort of strange set, the iPad thing there, whatever it is, it was a sticker on that brick there. These are the figures, that's the Pokemon there. I just lost a leg, you can sort of see what we're dealing with here. Mind you, some parts are printed, came with an extra limb there and an extra piece there, and I'll take a look at this pokey ball player here. One thing I will say, they have got like an anime style face to this. Of course the cap comes off, some bits of this snap on really tight, other bits come off far too easily. Yeah, what's on the back? It's blank on the back. That's the Pokeball. On the box artwork it shows a split color, but the ball there is only red. I'll put it this way, I've seen worse minifigures than this, and I've seen better. This is like your mid-range minifigure. Yeah, the very opportunistic, curious thing that, isn't it? $2 is actually extremely cheap for what you're getting there. A Lego minifigure, a licensed one in Australia, is $5 as I make this video, as the whole thing goes crumbling down there. We're going to take a look at, I believe it's Ash and Pikachu next. Maybe I should have showed you the box artwork here first before we start taking a look at the goods inside. And it gets very curious if you take a look at the back. I can only assume they are the other sets that were available, and I do believe I saw all those sets for sale. For $2 out of that box of knockoff blah blah, that's what you get. We'll take a look at the digital device first. It is just like the other one. That is a sticker that is on those bricks there. You can see it's the same sort of bricks that Lego used, but they're not as nice as Lego. And when we take a look up here next, I'm going to actually take a look. I believe it's Ash. I hope it's Ash. He's on there very tight. Like I said, it's very consistent the way these things join. You just heard it go pop. Okay, let's take a look at this one. Yeah, they've got the anime style there. I do believe the face. I think that looks good. A bit rough nut in the way the plastic has got some gnarly bits on there. The Pokeball is not split colored like it shows in the box. He is dressed up a bit. Okay, legs like that. They're actually pretty crummy minifigures when you look at the way the legs go together, because they do come in pieces, and when you put them together you sort of go, oh yeah, this is not Lego. This is something totally different. But nevertheless, just dropped the Pokeball. You won't win like that. It's not the worst I've seen. I've seen far worse than this. The Pikachu in this is, I think, very curious. Look at the way it's been designed. You can get ideas of how to make your own Pikachu here. It has a printed tail. That looks pretty good. It's got a printed face on it as well. Look at the way they've done Pikachu's ears there, those pieces there. I shouldn't be praising it, but put it this way, you know, it's not too bad. To me, it does look like Pikachu. It has been very curious to see how the dark side has jumped on the Pokemon Go, and look what it's delivered. These things were selling like hotcakes. I mean, there were big boxes in some stores I saw, and they were selling hard and fast. Just let me clear the knockoff Lego away from the table here, and I'll just explain to you what I'm going to do next to help me get through the Pokemon dark side. Pokemon trading cards are probably one of the most knocked off things going about. Of course, when Pokemon Go came along, guess what we started to see? These were selling for between 50 cents to $1 a pop. I think it was quite crazy to see how the price dumped to flog this. Sets like this, They look impressive, don't they? They were $2.50, but they are not real. A tin like that was $8, the price is on there. Okay, tins like this were $4, or they could be $5, the price did vary. And often you would see things like this, and they're all knockoff cards in there. They're basically $1 a pack. In Australia, if you're going to buy the real Pokemon cards, you're up for about $6 for a pack like that. So the cruel maths to that is these are selling for about 1/6 the price of the real deal. There was one thing that my daughter pointed out to me about the fake cards, and it's not my strong point, and that's like I'm going to ask someone for help, but I'll just show you one thing that we noticed. Looking at the knockoff Pokemon cards would almost be worth a video all by itself. I'm not going to get caught up right at the moment looking at this too hard. But they can be quite impressive. You can see the holographic patterns in that one there. But anyone who really knows the cards, you'll know that the values on these cards can sometimes be inconsistent. Cheat cards in a sense. The artwork can also be inconsistent. And on the other side of these cards, often you'll find that the artwork can be all various colours. The balls can be yellowish. These ones actually don't look too bad. I've actually got a great example down on the table. Yeah, I'm going to give you a good one here. Look at that. You get these colour change ones that are just sort of wrong. The other thing that my daughter pointed out to me was the knockoff ones delaminate really easily. The real cards don't do that. But also, the knockoff cards have just got a certain flimsy feel to them. They don't feel like the quality you get with the real cards. Here's a look at the packaging of the most recent ones. I mean, it is criminal, isn't it, what they get up to? That's what it reads there. And there is another read just there, which really does make you think, what is going on here? There were tons of these sets of Pokeballs for sale. Look in there, there's little things inside there. I'm going to open up one because I think I'm going to have to bleed over to another video. I've got a special friend who's going to open up that blue ball. Mr. Hammer, he even works when he's armless. It's just taken off. That was scary. I have recovered the critter from inside this Pokeball. Aren't they great balls, the ones which are blue like this? Okay, I'm going to give another whack, see if I can't kill it this time. Okay, Mr. Hammer, do your thing. Wow, that thing is tough. Okay, I'll give it one more whack. Look at that. Really going to hit it hard. Okay, here we go. I think I totally missed. This thing is indestructible. I can't believe this. Okay, come on. I'm going to really nail it this time. Mr. Hammer doesn't work without arms, does he? Okay, here we go. I'll probably do my camera in. It's disappeared. I'm not sure if you know, but when sometimes you smack something, it takes off at such a high velocity, it goes to another dimension. Well, that's what happened to the other side of that Pokeball, but look at the indentation on that, how much punishment it could take. I mean, this thing is seriously tough. And I mean seriously, virtually indestructible. I'm very surprised about that. But nevertheless, this is the critter that came out of that. I could really go crazy with Mr. Hammer, but I won't. It's a very, very rough nut Pokemon there, and I think you'll find that all those Pokeballs produce complete rubbish like that every time. Okay, please hear me out and listen to me very carefully at this point of the video. I'm going to try and find a Pokemon channel on YouTube that can help me finish off this video. I want someone who really knows their cards, who really knows their franchise toys, and who especially really knows these guys here. I'm sure these are rips of earlier toys, and I'm hoping that someone's got something like that that they can make direct comparisons to. I think that's really important to do. The person I choose will also get a sprinkling of these very, very strange minifigure sets. I don't think there's anything you can compare with those, but they are very, very oddball. So if you think you're a big Pokemon channel on YouTube and you're up for a challenge and you find knockoff stuff difficult to get, I know there are some countries where finding this stuff is actually very hard. Here's an opportunity to key into some of this dastardly knockoff stuff, and then you can do a nice comparison for me, because I know the person who I choose is going to be a Pokemon expert. The tricky part for me is finding this very large Pokemon channel to connect with to these toys. I'm sure there's going to be someone out there who'd be very keen to get their hands on these to make a comparison. And if you're doing something in conjunction with my channel, I guarantee your video is going to become very popular. So if you think you're the channel that can finish off the video for me, please send me a message on YouTube and nothing else. Send me a link to your channel, I'll take a look at your channel. I'll choose someone in short time and you can finish the video for me after I send you the toys. As always, thanks for watching and bye for now. And watch this Pikachu do his little dance.